Hi, welcome to Cheat Talk. Today I will be making a raw cake. Yeah, that's right, a raw cake. It is delicious and simple to make. All you really need is a few things, like a high-speed blender. I happen to have a Vitamix here. And a special cheesecake pan, the one that the sides pop off. Okay? And so we'll start with the crust is walnuts, and it's 2 cups of walnuts and 1 cup of dried dates. Okay? And then, of course, I'm going to be putting in a scoop of, or 2 scoops rather, of Miele in it as well. And all we're going to do is put it in the blender and then at low, no higher than 4, and just kind of pulsate it until it becomes fine. You can do it crunchy if you like, it's up to you. Okay? So I'll go ahead, mix that in, and then I will turn it on and oops, a couple fell off. Okay? And then I will grind that first, just so you know, that's what I do with this first, typically. Okay? Okay, as you can see, I'm pulsating on low, no more than 4. When I first turned it on, it was a little high, but anyways. And then you just do that for, you know, a minute or two, and that's pretty much it. I will now mix the Miele in. So 1 scoop, 2 scoops. Miele, by the way, is amazing. It kind of gels it up and gives it a nice texture as well. Okay, that's pretty much that. Alright, now I'm going to put the dates in. It's 1 cup of dates. Again, at low. Okay, now that I've did the dates, it takes a little bit more time, and you just do it slowly. And sometimes the motor burns out if you do it too long, if you leave it. But with this thing, just let it sit, and it resets 20 minutes later or something like that. I've done that many times, so not to worry if that happens. Now, just basically going to put it in. Okay, now I'm just going to use a little scooper, I guess, to get the bottom end, the last pieces out. Alright. And I'll just press it down. Okay, and then I just use a fork to kind of just pat it down. And as you can see, that's pretty much how you do it. It's pretty simple, straightforward, it's easy. Okay? Literally took me about 5 minutes, no longer. Okay, now we're going to do the filling. And it's cashew like butter. And so what I do, I go to Longo's sometimes and I just pick up one of these, you know, the whole the salt ones. One of these is exactly 3 cups. You don't need to really measure it. Just use that. Otherwise, you use 3 cups of cashews and you soak it for about 3 hours. Okay? And this is what it looks like, pretty much soaked for about 3 hours. Okay? Okay, so now I basically strain the cashews and I pour them in. And what I'm going to do now is put in some liquid, basically 3/4 cup lemon juice that I squeezed fresh. And it's typically about 3 lemons, okay? Nice size lemons, normally. If they're smaller size, I think 4. About 3/4 cup. And then 3/4 cup honey or agave, your choice. And today I'm doing agave. And 3/4 cup coconut oil or butter. Okay, and then basically you blend that up, a pinch of salt, and away you go. Then you pour that into the on top of the crust, and you put it in the freezer. You let it settle for about 15 minutes, and then you can put the topping on. It's that straightforward, simple. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and blend. So now I squeeze the lemons and 3/4 cup. Voila. Okay, now I have 3/4 cup agave, and again, you can use honey, whatever you like, is either one. All right, now I'm just going to put 3/4 cup coconut oil or butter, and scoop it in.
Okay.
And a pinch of salt. There you go, that's a pinch. Nice pinch. Nice pinch. Okay, that's a pinch of salt. And then I'll blend it up. I blended it and it took me about a couple minutes to blend, and now I'm just pouring it in. Okay? And then all we do here, after we blend it in, we put it in the freezer for about 20 minutes. Let it settle. Delicious. Okay, now I'm going to make the topping, and you can use any berry you like. You know, it's just frozen berries. 2 cups. I happen to be using blueberries, but strawberries work, raspberries, or even blackberries. And basically all it is 2 cups, and I pour it in. The whole time that I've been blending, I use the dry container. And then I'm going to be putting in some dates. Now you can put in however many you want just to sweeten it up. I happen to put, I don't know, about 6 small ones, but you can do 2 bigger dates if you have the bigger ones. It's a preference thing, okay? And then just blend it, again on low. And then it comes to like a smooth puree, and you put it on top, and you're done. Voila! And after that, I just spread on the blueberries, and away you go. I mean, it's very simple and easy, as you can see. You know, people will be very impressed, you know, when you serve this. And basically, this is very easy, and you can keep it in the fridge or even the freezer. So if you keep it in the freezer, you're gonna, you know, keep it for a longer time. Otherwise, in the fridge for a couple days, and you can have it anytime. Okay. It is a delicious dessert that's going to feel, you're going to feel good after, and you won't feel bloated. If anything, raw cuisine, the desserts rock. Truly, I'm telling you, when you try this, you'll be like, wow, this is awesome. So, I hope you enjoy, and bon appetit, or bon appetito, and we'll see you next time on Cheat Talk.